Yo, what's going on, guys? It's Houston Sports Talk back in another video today, and it's starting to feel like the true NFL offseason is starting to begin. Two big hirings in the NFL today. Well, one is kind of a trade slash hire with the Sean Payton news that we are talking about today. My Houston Texans got their head coach in D'Amico Ryans. Really excited about that. Already posted a video about that. If you want to go hear me talk about that, go check that out. That's already up. And I'll put the link in the description. But the other huge thing that happened today that I don't think anybody thought would happen. I mean, everybody kind of thought that if Sean Payton was going to go anywhere, it was going to be Denver. But I don't think that people were starting... I don't think people were... thinking this was definitely going to happen, like, right away. But I think after Denver kind of knew that they were not going to get D'Amico, which they really wanted D'Amico. D'Amico told them he was not interested anymore. He wanted to go to the Texans. And once they knew that was no longer in question, that they were not getting D'Amico Ryans, I think they probably asked about Jim Harbaugh. I don't think he's coming to the NFL. I think he's staying down in Michigan. So then they pulled the trigger for Sean Payton. Now, if you're into picks, which I would say it's important for this year's draft, I would guess. They had to give up some draft considerations for Sean Payton just because of he's still under contract with the Saints for 2 years. So you had to give them two picks to acquire Sean Payton. And so here is the trade, basically. It's so weird to say trade for a head coach, right? So the Saints do get the 2023 first round pick that the Broncos have, which will be the 30th pick in the first round, and then also a 2024 second round pick. The Broncos get Sean Payton, of course, and also a 2024 third round pick. This is awesome for the Broncos, man. I mean, not only do you get Sean Payton, but you get a third round pick in return. Who cares about a third round pick? But you didn't just have to give up a first and a second just for Sean Payton. You got another pick with Sean Payton, so I guess that's all right. But Sean Payton's gonna bring so much baggage than a third round pick because, I mean, not only do you got the presence of an amazing head coach, which I also think, if you look at the picture, I think that will make the man on Sean Payton's right way better. Russell Wilson, I think it starts with him. I think he has a way better season if Sean Payton is going to be their head coach. So I think for sure Russell Wilson does have a better season. I thought that Russell Wilson was playing extremely better when they fired Hackett in their first two or three games that they played without Hackett. I mean, two games, that's not enough to intel somebody without a new coach. But what I will say is that Wilson looked more like he was in Seattle than he was, you know, the whole season. So I thought Russell Wilson showed things in their final two games when Hackett was fired that he did not show when Hackett was the head coach. And that's just some, I don't know who their interim coach was when they fired Hackett, but that's just some interim. Imagine how Russ will play when you add in Sean Payton. I think this defense gets better in 2023. This defense was, you know, on its way to, you know, I think probably top five defense last season. They had their good moments. They had their bad moments as well. I think this defense excels next year. I think with Sean Payton, I think free agency, that the Broncos are going to be a hot place to go to in 2023. And Sean Payton is the big reason why. I wouldn't be surprised if maybe, I know the Broncos, they're kind of limited on picks right now because of doing this trade, but I wouldn't be surprised, and he could be cut, but I wouldn't be surprised if the Broncos have some interest in trading or signing Michael Thomas, a guy who I think Russell Wilson would be really good with. I think, you know, bring him back and reunite with Sean Payton. I think Michael Thomas could need someone like his old friend Sean Payton. I think that he could be a good fit in Denver to add to that wide receiver group. Like, Jerry Jeudy had a great 2022 season, but I think they just need some more wide receiver help. I mean, Jerry Judy's nice. I like Sutton, but it just feels like he can't stay healthy. But I don't know why to add it. Now I think about it. I don't know why you add in Michael Thomas, because if you already have a problem with a guy in Michael Thomas who can't stay healthy, I mean, if you already have a problem in a guy with Courtland Sutton who has a lot of injury problems, I don't know why I'd get another one, Michael Thomas. So maybe a guy like in free agency like DJ Chark you have interest in. I don't know. I think DJ Chark could do really well with Denver. But I think they added another wide receiver to help Russell Wilson get better. I think also possibly I could see them being interested in Mike Gesicki. I think they might want to add in another tight end to help Russell Wilson in the 2023 season. So I think they're going to bring in a tight end for Russ. I think they're going to bring in a third wide receiver next to Sutton and Judy. I think that they will ultimately, I think they'll end up making some changes with the defense. Not too many. I don't know what they'll do with running back, but you know, man, I think that this Broncos team with their head coach and maybe, you know, a couple additions, they should be a playoff team. It just depends on how Russell Wilson plays. And I think under Sean Payton being the head coach, I think that they should be just fine. I think that, and I don't want to jinx anything, because last season, I hate to call it last season. There it is. That's the video I made on D'Amico. But I hate to call it last season, because that's, we're kind of getting to the point. There's only one game left of this 2022 season, the Super Bowl. So basically last season. But before this season started, I was very high on the Denver Broncos. I think a lot of people were very high on the Denver Broncos. I had high belief in them. I thought Russell Wilson was going to have a great 2022 season. I thought, you know, things were going to go great for them. And it didn't. So I don't want to jinx anything, but I do think that now with the proper head coach, under the proper head coach, and I think with some key additions in free agency, whether it's to the defense or to the offense, or, you know, either sides, I think that this Denver Broncos team can be really scary next year. Now, it's not, they're not going to win the division. They'll be a wild card team. They're not going to win, you know. I had the guts to say they would win the division last year. But I think Mahomes will get a wide receiver, an actual wide receiver one going into next season with Kelce. So in that case, Mahomes is even dangerous. But it's so hard with the Chargers too, but I do think the Broncos will finish second in the division and be about the 5 or 6 seed in the AFC. And that's not a bad spot to be in. I mean, no offense to the AFC South, but if you're the 5 seed, you're basically playing the Jaguars, so or whoever wins it, the Jags or the Titans or the Texans or the Colts. I mean, honestly, with our division, I mean, anybody can win it. Actually, I think anybody can win our division besides the Colts. And I'm not just saying the Texans could win their division just because I'm a Texans fan. But I honestly don't think the Texans will win their division next season. But I'm saying there's just a chance, because now we have the right head coach, an easy schedule, a rookie quarterback who should be really good, and an easy schedule, like I said, and a horrible division. I think with a horrible division, has never been a head coach, so I can't say he's going to be assume that. But I think will be a really good head coach. I think another, you know, huge rookie quarterback. I think there's a chance we could win the division. But I think with some of the moves the Jags are going to make this offseason, also getting Calvin Ridley into the offense, there's no way the Jags don't win the AFC South. So, you know, possibly if the Broncos would be the 5 seed, you'd probably be playing the Jags in the first round. And honestly, in Jacksonville, they probably lose in the wild card. But I think it's way too early to be thinking about wild card for next year. But I'm just trying to make a look out here. I mean, who knows what will happen next season. I think that Sean Payton in Denver will be really good next season. And I think that they will definitely be the wild card. You know, 5, 6, or 7 seed, either one, I don't know. But we'll see what happens. You guys let me know your thoughts on the hiring. And peace out. Definitely a great move for Denver. And we'll see what they do in free agency. and in the later drafts. I mean, you don't have a first round pick. You gave up your first round pick to land this beauty of a head coach. And I don't know what their picks are looking like in the later round, but maybe they can make some adjustments there as well. But that's it for the video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know your thoughts, and peace out.